Please come in. Good evening, please be seated. Please give us a brief introduction.
Hi sir, I am Devashish. I am from Parikur, Chandigarh.
Devashish, what is your full name?
Devashish Patra.
Devashish Patra, okay.
My early education was in Gopinath Vidyapeeth Charchak. I have completed my plus 2 from Vijay Vijayanagar College, Bhubaneswar. I have completed my B.Tech from ITR Bhubaneswar in Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering branch. After my B.Tech, I have joined HCL Technologies as a software engineer. After working 2 years there, then I switched to an Indian startup called Criterion Networks, and there I am working as a technical lead. So presently I am working there. In 2017 I got married and I have one son who is 1 year old.
Okay. So your family stays with you?
Yes, they stay with me.
Okay. Your date of birth is 7th of June?
7th June 19th.
Yeah, I just needed the date and the month. 7 June, can you tell me what is the importance of 7 June?
Sorry,
sir. Importance means on that day.
Yes.
Any great personality who was born, any great historical event from the point of view of Odisha, India, world, which has happened. So, you remember your roll number for this exam?
201072.
201072. Okay, and your optionals were?
My optionals were geography. First optional is geography and second optional is Indian literature language, Odia.
Odia literature. Okay. You have done your 10th standard from Gopinath there, Vidyapeeth. Okay. So your home district is Puri?
Yes.
So, have you heard the name of Chandan Hazuri?
Chandan Hazuri, I heard it, but I'm unable to.
He was one of the survivors of Lord Jagannath, who also participated in the 1857 War of Independence.
Yes, yes, yes.
He had some connection with Rani Lakshmi, right?
Yes, yes.
His actual name was not Chandan Hazuri, I think.
Chaki Kundia. Chaki Kundia. Because he
was a survivor, he was called. Okay, so how many sub-divisions are there in Puri district?
There are mainly 3 divisions, but the sub-divisions are 49.
I think you are talking about blocks and tehsils.
Yes, there are 14 blocks. 314 blocks.
314 blocks in Puri alone?
No. Not in Puri, in Odisha I am saying.
No, I am talking about Puri.
Yes.
In Puri, how many subdivisions are there? And how many blocks and tehsils are there?
One is Brahmagiri, one is Krishnaprasad, and one is Manut.
3 subdivisions are there?
Sure,
so you go to the district website puri.mic.in,
yes.
Get all the details.
Okay.
Sure. Okay. Right. Satpada is in Puri? Satpada?
Yes.
Why it is famous?
Satpada is famous for its dolphins.
Which kind of dolphins they are?
There are basically 2 kinds of dolphins found in Chilika, but I don't remember the exact species of.
They are called Irrawaddy dolphins. Okay.
Irrawaddy dolphins.
Based on the Irrawaddy River. Do you know where Irrawaddy River is?
Irrawaddy is in Andhra Pradesh.
Andhra Pradesh? Are you sure? Just check there, okay, where Irrawaddy River is. Right. Okay. So last 5 years you have been in Bangalore. Bangalore, okay. What is the Kannadiga or Kannada name, Kannada meaning of Bengaluru? Can you tell?
What's the meaning of
Bengaluru in Kannada? There must be some name because it was given by the British as Bangalore. Right?
Yes.
And then the local people made it.
They have changed.
That means something, right? Bengaluru. So since you are staying there for so long, you should know that. Okay, which government is there in power now?
Currently, JDS and coalition government of JDS and Congress.
Currently, there is a coalition government of JDS and Congress. Who is your chief minister now in Karnataka? Yediyurappa is the chief minister.
Sorry, sir. Again, they broke up and BJP came to them. Sorry, sir.
Okay, fine. So, 12th you have done from BJP Junior College. Tell me the full name of Bakshi Jagbandhu.
Bakshi Jagbandhu Vidyadhar Rai Mahapatra.
Brahmara Bala?
Brahmara Rai Mahapatra.
Okay. So, what was his contribution to the history of Odisha, Bakshi Jagbandhu's contribution?
Yes. He was the chief, army chief of Raja Mukunda Devo of Khordagada. He was a prominent leader of Paika Vidroha along with Jai Rajguru.
Along with Jai Rajguru?
Jai Rajguru.
Okay. So, what was the reason of the Paika rebellion?
Against the British rule. I mean, when they invaded Odisha in 1803, so against the British rule of exploitation and all, so the Paikas were against them and they wanted to just subdue the British and throw them out of Odisha. That's why in 1817. They started rebellion against the British.
They started rebellion against the British rules. Okay. BTech you did from ITI Bhubaneswar. 2012, huh? You
yes.
finished your
yes,
BTech in 2012.
Yes.
And directly, you, same year, you
same
went year. To Tamil Nadu, huh?
Yes. No, no. Actually, I got placed in Institute of Technologies in 2012, but actual joining letter came in 2013. Actually, they conducted one more round of test in that around the end of 2012. They called it as front runner program. So we got selected across India in Institute of Technology that financial year. We went to Delhi and appeared one more exam. So whoever has cleared that exam, they posted them in several offices.
Awesome.
That's why it took one year for them to give the join.
Okay. So first you started your career as a software engineer.
Yes.
Now you are a technical lead.
Yes.
In which domain are you working? Can you tell me just about the nature of your work?
Initially I was working in Java. Initially, I got trained in Java only when I joined HCL. So after that, I got placed in a project which is a pure networking company called Juniper Networks. So I worked there for more than 2 years in that domain. So I got to know about the networking, core networking stuff. So I got more inclination towards networking and I got certified also. Networking fundamentals from HCL Technology. So after that, after completion of 2 years there, then I tried to learn, discover myself into more specific things in networking, like is software defined networking, which was evolving at that time. one of my seniors suggested me just explore that what it is. Then I tried to switch my job to a new company. Then I found this Kaitra Networks, a very good startup, and it's purely on HDM. So I attended the interview and fortunately I got selected and working in networking there.
So you're already around 6 years,
in IT services.
And why are you interested in shifting to civil services? Give me at least 3-4 reasons.
Sir, the primary reason is in IT actually when I joined the job, then my family condition was literally not good.
Okay.
That is why I was there to get a job, so I joined there. So gradually after working there, so it's kind of stable. So I'm not that much. I'm financially not that much dependent on anyone.
Mm.
Quite stable. So I can just because civil services was my core interest, but due to some reasons I was not able to be there. Focusing on other things, then after being stable, I try to switch to my interest. That is one of the main reasons. But the second reason, I would say that in my area, basically Chilika, whenever I go to that place, I see during my childhood I see the prosperity, but now if I see that, people are financially not strong. How they were before. There are a lot of issues happening over there. People are politically biased and kind of shifting to this party or that party. Their motive is to politically, basically they are politically oriented. They are not focusing on growth and development of that area. There are several issues because 90% of the people were dependent on fishery as their primary livelihood. Due to some government actions taken, most of them are jobless now. The prosperity is not that great now, and people are not even focusing on the development of our area. Intention is, I'm not able to see, but I just want to do something for my place so that at least I can give facilitated something. Because 4 things are basically needed there. The education system is definitely not good. The healthcare system also, there are no good hospitals there. They have to travel at least to Barhampur or Bhubaneswar or Cuttack for the basic needs. And one more thing is, people are not getting the benefits whatever the government gives. Mostly people are unaware of those schemes and all. That's why they are losing that. I think these things should be provided, education, health, that government schemes, facility, whatever intended for the people, they should get it. And definitely I work on this area to give my people.
Okay. So your hobbies are singing, karaoke. What is karaoke?
Karaoke is something the vocal part will be removed from the music. The music will be playing in the background and you have to give your voice instead of the actual singer's voice.
Okay. So it is more for fun.
Actually in my office they used to conduct some competitions and they used to give prize also. So they will play one music, karaoke music, whose accuracy level is good. Then there is a machine to measure it based on the frequency level.
Okay.
So whose accuracy is more, he will be given the award. So even I used to sing, so I have attended a couple of
writing Odia poem is your hobby?
Yes. During my childhood, I used to write many poems. My mother was like inspiration for me. But after the completion of my +2 BTEC and my job, I was not able to focus on it. But past before 2 years, when I have written a poem on my, regarding the status of our place, like what is the, what are the problems faced by our people, and what, how politically people are influenced, and someone is not there to guide them, give a guidance, proper guidance to our people. One of my senior, he is a social worker. He works for the people without any kind of advantage, or he don't need anything. Just he want to serve the people. So to appreciate him, I have written a poem for him to dedicate his good work.
Who is your favorite poet?
My favorite poet is Rathak Kapilwar Rajanath Rai.
Okay. Any one of his famous poems you can tell us the name?
Kapilwar Rajanath Rai is one of the best poems, Chitika.
What is the summary?
Summary, sir?
Summary of the poem?
Summary of the poem is he, the scenic beauty of Chitika, he explained quite well, very well even. And here he had seen a lot of places, he visited a lot of places in, around India, but he was not, he didn't get satisfaction from it. But when he came to Chitika, his mind was full of peace, and he just got quite a bit influenced with the Chitika and its beauty. So he wrote it.
Okay. So which poet is known as Kavi Surja?
Kavi Surja Baladevata.
You know some of his poems? That is the name?
I am not aware.
Okay. Cooking Indian dish. Indian dish, lot of Indian dishes are there. Odia cuisine is there. There you have South Indian cuisine. In Northeast there are different cuisines. Which cuisine?
Basically North Indian dishes like paneer or biryani. South Indian, if you say, I learned how to cook biryani. Paneer, if you say, I learned palak paneer and paneer butter masala.
Awarded as the best karaoke singer in my workplace, honored for best performer due to leadership and innovative ideas.
Yes.
Okay. In geography and Indian language earlier subjects. Okay. So in geography, let me ask you a question. You have studied about possibilism and determinism.
Yes.
What is the difference?
Environmental determinism is I'm not able to recall properly, but
okay,
I'd say
fine. It's like,
man. So they say that man is always rational and economic. So he tries to exploit the resources and take the benefit out of it. That's what this is determinism, and there is something called possibilism. They say that before making anything, just think about the environment, what will be the impact on it, taking the environment into the consideration to build, if you want to build any project or any initiative, if you take, environment should be the concern and its impact should be analyzed. But I am not sure, sir, whether I have given the correct answer or not.
Okay. Tell me one erosional and one depositional landform that is formed by groundwater in karst topography.
Karst topography. Yes. In karst topography, actually, the exact name I cannot tell, but in karst topography, when the water comes down, something will be hanging and something will be deposited below the limestone deposits that will form stalactite and stalagmite. Yes.
Okay. So tell me something about the ancient Pancheshikas and the modern Pancheshikas in our literature. Who are the five ancient Pancheshikas? You've taken only literature, no?
Ancient?
Panchasakha. Panchasakha.
Oh, sorry, Panchasakha. Yes, sir. Panchasakha, ancient Panchasakha, Jagannath Das, Balaram Das, Achyutananda Das, Ananta Das, Yashovardhan Das.
Okay, and you know at least one composition from each of them?
Yes, Jagannath Das, Sankarachi, Bhagavata, Nya Bhagavata, Balaram Das, Sankarachi, Dandika Man. अच्युतानंद दास
posting is given, join as a tehsildar or deputy collector. difference between the role of a tahsildar and BDO?
BDO takes all the developmental purposes for the respective blocks. It takes public grievances as well. But tahsildar will work on the issues that are going on within the in their respective blocks. They'll try to mitigate the issues.
Okay. According to you, what is the most important virtue or most important, you can say, in a way, characteristic that should be there in a civil servant?
First thing. First thing should be the civil servant should be honest. And his intention should be redirected to the common people. He should think for the direct beneficiary, who are the common people. So in that way, he should formulate the policies or anything, if you want.
Mm-hmm. Okay, fine. Suppose you are a district officer. Okay. BDO or your tahsildar. Imminent flood is there in your place, okay, in tahsildar. Collector has asked you, you take the precaution, ensure that there will be no casualty.
Okay.
And there are a lot of boats are required. Government has not provided any boat. Mm-hmm. And within 2-3 hours, you need the boats. There is a local zamindar who is having 20-30 boats.
Yes.
That fellow is asking for money, lot of money. Means what is double or triple the price of actual, what he should take, even if he's charging, what are you going to do? He is not going to, you have tried to, persuade him, your seniors have tried to talk to him, he's saying,
money doesn't matter because if people get
from where will you get the money? Government will not give. Okay, government has a particular prescribed rate, let's say 100 rupees per boat. He is asking for 300 rupees per boat.
Is that money? I can arrange it.
From your own pocket?
Also,
from where will you earn it? From your own pocket?
May not be from my pocket.
Okay.
I can collect it because the I can claim that I have saved this many lives of people.
But will anyone listen? If as a government officer, you start collecting money from the public, I think
first, I try to convey the higher authority saying that this is the work which was needed for the people. I have done it, I have taken this step, but this costed me this much amount of money. I think government should give it. It should not hesitate to do that. Most priority should be given to the people. We should save their lives. Nothing is more money, definitely is not costly than their lives.
Why can't you take use force, confiscate his boats, okay, confiscate his boats, use the boats and then return? You can do that for the public good, okay.
So, boats?
His boats. He is saying that he will not give you unless he takes the money. You will take police and you will go and confiscate his boats for the public good that is being done. Government also acquires property. When it has to do, any good for the public, a road has to be built or something. The owner of the property may not like it, but he will be given some compensation by the government. Similarly, you will pay him 100 rupees which the government has, decided for the boat. Okay?
Okay, but after the flood goes away, then what should be done for him?
You give the actual money, government will give it. We have taken you 30 votes, 30 into 10, 300 rupees paid. That is the government rate. He was asking for 900 rupees. Okay. So you tried to persuade him. He did not agree, then according to law, you will take, because the life of people is important.
Yes.
Okay. The hypothetical situation,
yes.
Just to show what you're doing. Okay, so that will be the end of the interview. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.